Weirdly enough, when the Fukushima nuclear accident happened, I was not in Japan. I was in New York at a film festival talking about Yakuza films. Much like yesterday I was talking about Kitano Takeshi's film Aniki. And I wondered if there was going to be a natural disaster in Japan when I did that discussion yesterday. Fortunately, there was not. It was very strange because I was talking to someone on the phone as the earthquake took place. And I remember saying to him, and he was my boss at the time. I was working for him doing corporate investigations. And I remember saying to him, as he said, "Hey, wow, the building is really shaking," I said, "It sounds like you better get out of the building. Send me an email or text me later when we know what's going on." And you know, for a couple of days, I couldn't reach anyone. So it was very scary to go back to Japan. I remember going on the plane when they finally let planes back into Japan, and you know, there was almost no one on the flight. And I was thinking, am I crazy to be going back to this country? Because no one understood how bad the nuclear reactor situation is. Is Tokyo radioactive? Is there going to be an even worse meltdown? What is the situation? That was very frightening. And for the first couple weeks, there were constant tremors, even after the major ones. Middle of the night, you'd wake up, and it would feel like the ground was moving beneath you, and it was. Sometimes up and down, sometimes to the side, like made you feel like you were surfing. I mean, after a while, I got so used to it that I would, take a video of myself, like on one leg, surfing the latest wave, which I thought was pretty funny, but maybe other people weren't amused. So, yeah, it was a big deal. It took a while for me to actually even get out to Fukushima and see what the damage was. And even then, I had to do it covertly because there was so much of that area that was marked off limits by the Japanese authorities. Maybe for safety reasons, maybe because they didn't want anyone to understand how bad the damage was. The second part of the book is about discovering that there is something worse than the Yakuza, and that is Tokyo Electric Power Company and the giant industrial complex that allowed nuclear energy in Japan to go unchecked and unregulated and resulted in this terrible disaster that was man-made. And not just the result of a natural disaster, something that could have been avoided. I have a very wonderfully calm life these days. I report on the Yakuza less and less because their numbers have gone from 80,000 to 24,000. I haven't been severely beaten in 6 or 7 years. I have plenty of time to write, cover things that I want. Last year I spent, I'm 54 now. Last year I decided to do something new. So I spent an entire year working on a series of stories about people who went missing in Japan called The Evaporated, which was actually quite successful as a podcast goes. So I've never done a podcast before. So that was great. And this year I have no idea what I'm going to be doing. I know we're already in April, but between the release of this book and the second season of Tokyo Vice, I haven't started anything new. I haven't started a new book. I don't even know if I'll start a new book. So I'm just enjoying life for the moment.